I woke up this morning and realized that I was 18 years old. Like, the sun came up and I realized that I have existed on this earth for about 6,570 days. See, being a woman in this country, my life expectancy has been significantly shortened, and I realize that by the time I'm 19, I'll probably be dead or on the way to dying. So I thought it would be important for me to prepare for my funeral, to audition for the role of Corpsey. My funeral won't be like those other funerals. No, this one will put even Princess Diana's to shame. It'll be the greatest funeral there ever was. So great that they'll broadcast it across countries. I mean, the story of my death will be so Twitter worthy that you'll create hashtags that trend for 3 days. My face will be plastered across your statuses. You will call me Angel and tell me to rest in peace. I bet even the president himself will be there. Grace us with his presence. He will hold my mother's hand while she recites my eulogy, while her eyes fill with tears, while she chokes, and afterwards he will get up on that podium and give the best speech he has ever given, so perfectly written with every word, turning my life into a story to be remembered. He will tell you to remember my name, beg you to not forget me, and you will add me to the list of other names that we have had to remember since basically forever. And my body will lie in its casket, every inch of me covered in bruises, stab wounds made so expertly that you could call it art. I will become the latest backdrop for the Gents Let's Do Better campaign. They will promise to do better, change their DPs to purple, sing Protect Our Women till the cows come home, and I will smile from my grave, my dead lips forming a thank you, because that's what you want, right, gents? A thank you. A thank you for trying. Thank you for sharing. Thank you, thank you, thank you. My ghost will clap for you. A thank you for giving a shit about my life now that I'm dead or whatever. The way you gave a shit about Riva or Naledi or Evelyn or Tehofatso or the hundreds of other women, right? You give a shit and we die, right? I will form a thank you while I wait for the next body to fall, to come lie next to me, to come keep me company, because I know it won't end with me. See, when my soul leaves this earth, the first person I will see is Nene, and she will smile at me, that soft kind of smile. And Kwasa, she will take my hand and squeeze it just a little bit, just enough to remind me that I can still feel. I will be the latest addition to heaven's special welcome committee, practice my smile, practice my hug, ready to welcome the next girl, ready to tell her it wasn't her fault, that I was also just walking home, that I wore pants too, that I didn't make eye contact. I promise that I did everything they have ever told us to do since I was like 6. But still, he raped me. Still, he beat me. Still, he killed me. So I will tell her it wasn't her. Even if it feels like it, no, my funeral will be the greatest to ever be done. One for the history books, I swear. There are 294 days left before I turn 19. 294 more days of waking up with the sun, of breathing in air before a man claims his right to my body or his right to my life. 294 days of being terrified to leave the house, of hugging my mother tight so when I'm gone, she remembers the feel of my arms around her, of pausing at the door to wave goodbye to my dad. Half a see you later and half a goodbye forever, just in case. Just in case this is the last goodbye that I have, the last hug, the last kiss, the last time I get on the bus, the last time they see me as I am now, alive. I don't know if I'll make it to this time next year, or even if I'll make it to the end of this day. See, like every other woman in this country, I'm living on borrowed time, waiting. Waiting for my turn, for my big debut as victim number 1,000 and something. So Here it is. The audition tape to my funeral. How was that? Was that good enough? Did I get the part, sir? Did I break the little mother in you? Did I look victim enough? See, I was going for this murdered schoolgirl type of vibe, a closed casket type of silence. Cold, like an autopsy of a dead body.